والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى لا سيما محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وصحبه حق الدين والقدر العظيم. Glory to the Almighty Allah, I beg your loving care. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, the high, the exalted. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, mighty is your clothes. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, magnificent is your authority. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are so mighty. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are glorified in the highest. You hear and see what is under the sun. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are the witness over every whispered conversation. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are the place where every complaint are made. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are present in every assembly. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are the object of great hope. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you seize what is under the lowest part of water. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you hear the breathing of the fishes in the lowest depth of the ocean. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you know the weight of the skies. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you know the weight of the earth. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you know the weight of the sun and the moon. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you know the weight of darkness and light. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you know the weight of shadow and the air. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you know the weight of the wind. How much time it is lesser or greater than the weight of the dust. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, you are holy, you are holy, you are holy. Glory be to the Almighty Allah, I wonder how anyone who knows you will fear you not. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. I'm giving 25 minutes and I may just use like 10 or 15 minutes. Time to love. I will have even begged your pardon that I will just share the topic given to me and just make some comment on both the great lectures I've already here today. I will still go there. I'm starting from my sister. I'm very, very happy that we have a Christian in our midst. During the creation of Adam, the angels, they don't want Allah to create us. I don't know, maybe out of envy or jealous, but they don't want Allah to create us. They said we are going to cause commotion, we shed blood, but Allah told them, "Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun." I know what you don't know. This is what one of the things Allah knows that the angels don't know. People of diverse faith, we still sit together and do something in common. In honor for her, I want to honor her. I will recite the books of the New Testament. I'm a student of Bible knowledge. But our school, they taught us that Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Apostles, Romans, Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Ephesians, Colossians, Thessalonica, Thessalonica, Timothy, Timothy, Titus, Philip, Hebrew, James, Peter, Peter, John, 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 Revelation of John. That's okay, Allah Akbar. Allah Akbar. That is for my sister. She delivered a well, thank you, very much. She delivered a very beautiful lecture here today. I noticed one thing when she was delivering the lecture. She said, the topic given by was about neighbor. That is my most favorite topic ever in the world. When I saw the invite, I said, you have given me this topic, bro. But I'm happy she really deal with it. When we were in secondary school, I think I was in primary school. I was in primary school then. This secondary school, primary school, I don't know. Ebenezer always sang, make one rendition of the song that, Okwedo Okwedo, Ule Kiji, Tom Kigepa, Fire, Fire, Kipana, Fana, Tobi. Making your neighbor very, very important. I'm from Iloyin. I live in Mushi, in Lagos State. If anything negative, if anything negative is going to happen to me, before my family will hear in Iloyin, it's my neighbor that will call first. And my brother, Ashir, Abdurrahman, one of the most beloved names of Allah. You know, during this Ramadan, we used to do lecture at night. 1.5 hours every night. And I have been doing tafsir of just Ar-Rahman. Just that one ayah. Not the whole Surah Al-Rahman. You can't exhaust it. The mercy and compassion of the Almighty Allah is overwhelming. Sometimes I will just be saying, where is this coming from? But because the mercy, the compassion is available every year. You just have to open your eyes and see it. Open your ear and hear it. Everywhere Allah is merciful and compassionate. Our brother delivered a lecture on love of fellow human. Yesterday, I was in on Sunday, I was in the palace of Oniru. I now sang a song there again. We are taught that in secondary school also, song of praise. But whose name is love, happy children we, listen to the rain that we sing to. I have to lie, the topics are so beautiful. The topic given to me is about charity, the role of charity and social service in the building of the society. I don't know how you're going to start again. Let me just read this. As a creed, the spiritual essence of Islam is Tawhid, oneness of the Almighty Allah. Believing in the oneness of the Almighty Allah. And in practicing good manners, uprightness, and compassion. Compassion is the first fruit of faith. A soul without compassion cannot be considered alive. The first verse in the Quran is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim starts with the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. One of the most distinguished manifestations of compassion in this world is infaq, that is giving in charity for the sake of Allah. Creating a tranquil society by raising gracious, kind, and thoughtful individuals is one of the main goals of Islam. On a humanistic and civilization level, one of the most luminous pages of our historic inheritance are the effort to promote charity, endowment, and benefits. Let me relate a story now from Muhammad. It was related that the Prophet was about going out on a mission in the morning, and he is supposed to come back in the evening, later in the evening. He now told his wife, say that my Ummuna Aisha, that kill that ram and do justice to it. Kill that ram and do justice to it. Aisha now killed the ram, distributed most of it. She left just one in his name. She left one lap of the ram. When the Prophet now returned back in the evening, he asked Aisha, what did you do with the ram? He said, I give to this, to that, to that, to that. Remaining only the lap. Can you imagine what the Prophet said? He said that all the one that you gave out are the one that will remain for me, for us. The one that you left for us to eat is not our hope. Because when our sister was delivering this lecture, I just come. When you give somebody money, or you give the person a clothes, or you anything, give something in charity, in pity, in kindness, you might be fixing his life. You might be fixing his today, but by collecting it from you, you are, he or she is fixing your next tomorrow. Because people that are poor, or one way or the other, have physical challenges, we call them less privileged. But I call them the much more privileged. Because the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam make one hadith that it is not even only in Islam, in nearly all the religions of the world, I mean the three major religions as outbooks, utilizing Jews, Christians, and Muslims. That the hand that gives is always on the top. The Prophet also said this. The hand that gives is always on the top, but that is in theory from my prophet. In practice, I want to demonstrate something. Please, one minute. You are about to give me something. All this now. He's about to give me, my hand should be under. His one should be on top. If the prophet wants to give someone something, his hand is going to be under and he said, pick it. You are lifting me up. That is the pattern. There was a story again. It was said a woman was looking for child for long, like 10, 15 years. Later on, the Almighty Allah gave him a child. When the child was about 3 months old, she was about to swallow the last morsel while having dinner. One little child just come, like, let's say, one slice of bread, last slice of bread. The child was crying, I'm hungry. She gave the child that one slice of bread. I'm just making an analogy so that we begin to understand, not a muscle, a slice of bread. Like 2 months after, Ayati journey, she was cooking. She laid down the child beside the adugan. She went now in to come and bring the yam flour. That's you, Amala. Okay, she just saw that was just coming and just picked the child through the cloth. The wolf was running away with the child, and the woman was saying like this. Let me put that in Yoruba. Tanwa ni. You know when you are looking for child for long, and when you now get the child, you say tanwa. Tanwa ni. Egba mi. She was running. She was not tired. Just fell down. The Almighty Allah now sent an angel in human form to go and collect the child from the wolf and return it back to the woman. When the angel now bring back the child, the woman was so happy. And the angel now tell the woman that I'm an angel from the Almighty Allah. A lokuma. A muscle that you refuse to swallow, even when you need it, was replaced. Allah denied the world to also swallow your child. But what is happening to human beings? As we become slaves to materials, gold, money, property, fame, power, all this. What is wealth? If it's not spent in the way of the Almighty Allah. When they tell you, spend in the way of God or in the way of the Almighty Allah, what does it mean? They are telling you to spend in humanity. It was relayed that the Prophet was circumambulating the Kaaba, and even the Kaaba. He and Sayyidina Umar. Nowadays, we build mosques, we build big churches, we build a lot of things. Building, we are mad. That is what is so mad. Big ones, the church is big, this mosque is so packed, all those stuff. The Prophet was circumambulating the Baitul Aziz, which is the major place of worship in Islam, the center of focus. The Prophet now points to the Kaaba. Ma ajmaluk, ma abuhak. You are so beautiful. You are magnificent. And now the Prophet was talking to the house. La urmatu abdu mu'min hayru inda Allahi wa hurmatik. The honor, the dignity, the sacredness of a human being is greater in the sight of Almighty Allah than your sacredness. Let me give you a story again. I will soon round up. There was a man and a woman married, wife and husband. The other was very, very sick. In fact, sickness of death. Surely that he's going to die. Like 3 days before the man dropped dead, he saw that the wife was weeping.
now told the wife that my wife, why are you looking like that? I mean, deep puna. I'm going to miss you, sir. I will miss you so much. This was during the time of Nabi Elijah Musa. I'm going to miss you. Now the man now told the wife that I will not get decayed. Don't bury me. You Almighty Allah will get me embalmed. I will not decay. The woman now created a portion in the house and laid the husband there. For 2 years, she visits every Friday. The husband looked fresh. Hayyan Toriyan. I mean, so supple. Like 3 months after then, she did not go at all to visit the room. When she now went there, she saw that one of the right ear of the man has decayed and just cut off. She was now crying, yeah, my husband, at last, this is the end. You lied. You said you are not going to get decayed forever. The Almighty Allah now gave the dead, the man, the husband, the capacity to talk and reply to the wife. Said, my wife, I never lied. Said, the reason why you saw that ear of mine decayed and cut off from my body was that there was a day I was passing by and someone was telling me, help me. I did not answer. The part of my body, that part of my ear that hears that, that was one that decayed.
Allah.
Humanity. We are here for humanity. There are two ways to serve God. Two ways. Two major ways to serve the Almighty God. One is horizontal, and the second one is vertical. Everybody have the belief that the Almighty God is up. Although he's everywhere, he's omnipresent. But you should not think less of God than by saying Allah is under the soil. No. You have to put in what is lying in the Masalul A'la. If you want to give a similitude of where I am, it should be up. It doesn't mean that he lives here and he's not in another place. But everybody tends to believe that Allah is up. So we try to go to the mosque, to the church, or any other way. Monastery, anywhere people go to worship God, sing the praises of God, invoke the names of God, conjure some good eulogy of the Almighty God. But still, we try to neglect the other one, the vertical one. And the vertical one is what is between you and the other person, between you and the other creation of God. There was a story related by the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, there was a woman, Al-Fajra. In another hadith, he called the woman Al-Fasika. Poki, Eshe, exemplified. Eshe, personalized. They mean all types of sins she commits. She was now going one day, she was testing. He gave near to one well. She was about to drink water. She used a shoe to collect the water. She was about to drink the water now. She now saw one dog. And she knows that the dog is so thirsty. She now sacrificed that time of her drinking the water and gave that dog the water to drink. The Prophet said, with that, all the sins he committed, Allah forgive him. That's my lecture. Oh Allah, the real owner of sovereignty, let all the manifestation of charity, service, mercy, and compassion on your part be the endless treasure of our spiritual lives.